I want to welcome everybody and thank you for the introduction. So my topic today is Star Trek-based Linac QAid for electron photon and photon flattening filter-free radiation therapy. Let me start with a short overview of our facility. So we have six Linacs. We have four Elektra Synergy Linacs and we have two Elektra Agility Linacs. One is able to perform flattening filter-free. We have it since January this year, and we already treated more than 10 patients with flattening filter-free. So we have various equipment of IVA devices. We have two times the Blue Phantom with various ionization chambers, with the diodes, with the diamond ionization chamber, and we have four Star Trek devices, and we have three Matrix devices, and we also use Compass software. So the Linac QA we perform with Star Trek at our clinic is the 2 weeks QA. We mostly focus on the light and radiation field coincidence, and of course the profiles, energy, and absolute dose outputs. Also from various gantry angles here, and from four different dose rates. And you can either position the Star Trek on the couch, or also with a dedicated holder on the gantry mounted on the gantry. Our QA procedures are, of course, following the task group report from AAPM or the German DIN. The Star Trek 2D array detector the application is the routine QA for high energy photon and electron beams. The measuring quantity is absolute dose. Absorb dose, and the specification, it has roughly 450 ionization chambers. They are located mostly on the in-plane and the cross-plane field, and the diagonals as well. And the resolution changes, so it's between 5 millimeters for the in-plane and cross-plane, and 7 millimeters for the diagonal way. There are two different build-up plates, 5 centimeter thick photon build-up plate and a 1 centimeter thick electron build-up plate, which will come with a detector. The software, monitor working with the Star Trek device, is the OmniPro Advanced software. You can also use it with the Matrix device in case you don't have the Star Trek. So it's mainly built from, so it has four sections. The first section is the setup queue. In the setup queue, you can create and edit your test queues according to various given or templates for protocols, also according to the APM or the German DIN again, or the vendor-specific protocols, or you can define your own one. And you just set up your queue once, and you can use it in the measurement and analysis section, and this is where you perform your QA measurements. In the third section is the data archive, so you can compare and analyze all your test results which you acquired over the last years, you can say, and you can select different time intervals, you can evaluate the different profiles or the those output, and you can have a trend analysis of the stability of your linear accelerator. And in the last section, it's fast track. This is a free measurement mode, and it's supporting you in very easy, quick measurements after, for example, a Linac maintenance. Let me just give you a more detailed overview for each section again. So here's the setup queue. Since we have Elektra Linux, we have as a database or the system which controls the Linux in clinical mode is the Mosaic electronic recording system. And if you want to optimize your QA performance as much as possible, then you can just define in the setup queue your 2 weeks QA, 3 months QA, annual QA, and you have just the whole workflow there, and you can also in Mosaic just generate a QA patient and you just order the same beams which you want to irradiate already, and then it's a straightforward QA performance, which is very easy. In the measurement and analysis section, you have four different measurement characteristics. So you have the profile analysis, which is mostly checking for the field width and the penumbra and symmetry and flatness. This is recorded by the in-plane and cross-plane direction, or the diagonal direction, and you just have your references from the setup queue and you compare it. And then you have the energy verification, which is generated by eight, as you can see here, by eight ionization chambers, which are positioned. So you have you just try to simulate different depths by having the different build-up plates. So for photons, you will generate two depths, and for electrons, you will have eight depths. You will see an example later of the look. And the third section is the dose output. The dose output is generated by the nine central chambers, and it's just the average of it. And the last one is the wedge constancy check. You can check the slope of the wedge then. For the measurement and analysis tool, you should, before you start your measurements, you should make sure that your device is calibrated correctly. This one you should do once you receive the device and you set it up for one LINAC. You have to make sure it's calibrated on absolute dose. This is a so-called K user factor here, and you just use the predefined or the stable dose for your LINAC. So I guess for most of the people it's the same, that you deliver 10 monitor units in 10 centimeters build-up or in 10 centimeters steps from SSD 100 centimeter, and this should give you one gray. And this one you have to just measure with your Star Trek device and calibrate it. The other calibration performance is the uniformity correction. So it's basically a gain correction. So you just, in case your ionization chambers, they don't read out the same way, all these 450 ionization chambers, and you just even them out, and everything is reading out the same. So you get your profile flat, you can say. And you can set your background measurement time. Before you start measurements, you have to always generate a background just for the daily pressure and temperature settings. Okay, and this one is an example for profile analysis. You see here 15 mega electron volts and 18 MV photons beams. So you can see here, this is the interface. It's very easy. Easy and very user-friendly. You can directly see your, so here's the queue which you opened, and here's the profile, the result, and here you see your protocol references, and so you have some tolerances, and if your measurement is within the tolerances compared to the reference you set in your setup queue, then you will see a passed or a fail. So if everything is green, everything passed. Okay, the same for the photons. Let me just show you a small, this one might be interesting for most of you. It's the new technique, filter-free, flatting filter-free. And so this is how the profile looks. We generated this data directly after our acceptance for FFF. And so we, of course, have to set the tolerance for the flatness quite high, because the flatness is just not given anymore. If you compare it to your reference data and everything is fine, everything is green. And right now we are developing a QA procedure for flattening filter-free, and we will, so the reference here, the paper from Fogliatta et al. Is a quite nice example for how to evaluate it. They basically take a look at the slope of the profile. You can analyze it, but yeah. So we are still under development for this one. This one is an example for the energy verification. Here you can see that for photons there are only two depths, so it's taking from each quadrant in the Star Trek, it takes the depth and it will average again. And here you see it for electrons. And you get your result compared to your reference which you set, and if it's all fine, it passes. This is a dose output example, so it will just basically also give you the dose which you measured with your device, and if it fits to your reference. So this is just the look, it's always the same, it's just the different measurement characteristics. Okay, and the third and the fourth section from OmniPro Advanced Software is the data archive is the third, and the fast track is the fourth. For the data archive is a very, very useful and very, very efficient tool. You can analyze and you can compare your measurements for all kind of different time periods. You can define the time, and you can see, okay, what happened if the LINAC is maybe not performing straight or well anymore, and you can have a long-term rating of the stability. And you can have a trend analysis of your LINAC performance, and you can of course also print out the tests, and you can store them in your database. For example, for us, we upload it into Mosaic just for safety, for safety issues. Okay, sorry, now I went too fast. In the bottom here, you see two examples. So you see first the dose output here. It's quite stable over time. This one was, I think it's for the last 3 months, if I'm not wrong. And this one is the symmetry. So, and the red bars are the tolerances you set, and the blue ones are your results from the day. And here you would, if it's not that blurred, then you would see the dates when you acquired this data. Another example is the inline profile. So here you might see that there's one red dot. So we once had a failure in the field size, but it was just on the border from the tolerance. So, and here you could overlay all the profiles from the previous measurements, and you can just compare the stability. The last section is the fast track. You can perform the measurements in the free mode. You don't have to pre-define any settings before, and you just directly put it on the couch and you can measure, and this is helping you a lot with the LINAC maintenance. For example, if you had some error in the field size, you can directly modify. Okay, now I already come to the end. The benefits of Star Trek. So first of all, of course, it's an electronic device which is directly connected to the software, so you directly see your measurements, and you can directly analyze, and so you don't have to use films, you don't have to calibrate films anymore, and you don't need to think about your setup that much anymore. You can just, it's very time efficient. The interface of the software is very user friendly. For the setup, for this the setup queue, is very helpful because you only set it up once, and you can always play your measurements directly. And so you once define your setup queue, and this is what you choose when you want to make a measurement. And there are various QA protocols given as a template already. The execution of your measurement is very time efficient. You can see that we only need 15 minutes for 2 weeks QA, and 1 to 1.5 hours for the 3 month QA, because you have to switch the position of your measurement device according to different gantry angles. You only have to perform one measurement for various characteristics from your energy. So you have the field parameters, you have the energy and the dose output in just one shot, you can say. You have an automated archiving, so you can compare your data, and you have a trend analysis, so you can analyze the stability of your LINAC. And it's very, very useful if you have some error and you can just see when it happened and where it happened. The export, you can of course export your data and you can print the tests out as a PDF, for example. And the fast track will support the maintenance. I already said that a couple of slides ago, but this one is the benefit section. And so it's a real-time measurement there. And just for IBA, a small suggestion. Since we match all our machines, it would be nice to have one database for all Linux together, so you can also compare your Linux in one file. But this is just a suggestion for the future. Okay, then I would like to thank my whole team from the Radiation Oncology Department in Mannheim, and of course, thank you for your patience and for listening to my talk.